Well, hi. So it's been a while since I made a video, but recently I've been getting a lot of requests to show how I made the Lock, Shock, and Barrel masks. If you haven't seen, I did make some videos about Lock, Shock, and Barrel, making costumes about them, and in them I did include some handmade, homemade masks. You can click somewhere around here, some title card, some link in the description to go see them, but this is a very quick how-to to make these masks. So, these masks. How do you make them? It's very, 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 very simple. You don't need a lot of stuff. Most of it you can find at Michael's or whatever craft store is near you. What you need is some craft foam, which can be found in the kids section normally. This is 12 pieces in 12 by 18, and these were perfect to make these slightly larger than my face masks. You could probably start with any color. I did start with the base color of every mask that I was going to make, so green, red, white. After that, you will need some tracing paper or drawing paper or anything that's big enough to trace something this size on so you can draft a pattern. After that, you will just need some glue. A hot glue gun usually is what I use. You could try super glue. I don't know if that will work. I do recommend a hot glue gun. Other than that, you need some acrylic paint, a very cheap mask that you can find at like Target usually has them. Grocery stores carry these, dollar stores, Halloween stores. It doesn't matter which mask you get. What you need is this had the black fabric that goes over the back of your head attached to it. That fabric, when you stretch it out, is pretty see-through. You will need that to make your eyes. I would recommend testing it, holding it up to the light and kind of stretching it over to see if you can see through it, because if it's too dense, you're gonna kind of wander blind. Even though these are hold up to your face masks, I can see through this pretty clearly. You will also need scissors and a craft knife or what have you that you have on hand, or a box cutter also works. I have used those in the past, but you need something so you can get the really easy pressed out lines instead of the really jagged ones that you will get only from scissors. The scissors really help with cutting out your pattern. And the thing that will save you and make these masks a lot more hardy and able to stand up to wandering around at night, going to a party, or just any old thing and give them a really cool texture is this stuff. It's the Mod Podge Stiffy. Now this is made for fabric and for stiffening up fabrics, like if you're putting a decorative bow on something and you want it to stay in place. But what it does for the craft foam is it gives it a slightly tougher, firmer texture so that it stays and it holds its shape. And now we're going to talk about the application process, how to put it all together. Now like I said, you need to start with a pattern, and so the pattern that I had is this. So I took a piece of tracing paper, and it's hard to see, but I do have all of my pieces drawn out on it. And what I did was draw out half of each face so I knew that everything would fit. Because what you can do, and what I did, since the pieces of foam that I had weren't big enough to cut out the entire head of all of them, is cut out half a head from each and then glue them together with just a seam down the middle. You might not be able to see it in all of the masks, but each of them does have a seam that cuts down the center of it because I made them in half faces. I did put the details on these outline on these sheets of paper. I do have the outlines of the eyes, I have the mouth, and I have the noses. So once I cut out each sheet of craft foam to the basic head shape, I could cut out the detail lines of what I needed. Using that same pattern, I found the places to cut out the eyes and the nose, and then where I needed the teeth to be. To make sure that I was cutting out the exact right place, I put the pattern on top of each face and pressed in with like a very dull pencil to make the indentations in the craft foam itself. So after that, with Lock and Shock, you also need to cut out the nose piece. So you need to cut out two identical nose pieces for the nose here. These are just gonna be two triangles. I would recommend cutting out one based on the shape from the pattern that you made. As you can see, I have like a little bit of the press out of the noses of each of them. This one I pressed a little too hard, but you see the outline of the nose shape. What you need to do is cut out two of those triangles and then make sure that they line up together when you push them forward. You also do need to cut out a bottom piece for your nose. So what I did was I cut out the two big pieces for the triangle parts of the nose, glued those on, and then traced right here to get the exact shape I needed to place in the nose. And I did glue that from the inside and not the outside, so I didn't see the weird seams on the bottom of here. It just goes straight in and under from the opposite side. Now, what you can't see in the photos and the videos that I posted of these masks is how messy they are on the other side. So to ruin the illusion of this beautiful mask, the backside is kind of a mess. But that's fine, people aren't gonna really see the backside. What I would probably recommend for you is to do two sets of each of the things that you traced out, each of your patterns, because I didn't, so I had to cut out random pieces I had left to reinforce the mask to make it stronger. So that's all these little pieces you see, and I did put a piece across the nose, reinforces the structure and make sure it doesn't start bending out from the nose. You also want to make sure you cut out any of the details. So while Lock and Shock have their noses, Beryl has his teeth. I wanted them to stand out, so I did trace again around the teeth from the pattern that I made to make two sets of teeth. That could be very 3D. It's hard to see on here, but you can kind of see that they stand out from the mask, and it just, otherwise Beryl tends to be very just flat, and I wanted to give him a bit of dimension. So his teeth. After that, I would paint them with the Mod Podge Stiffy. So that took me like two or three coats to make it the firmness that I wanted. They do have to sit and dry for a while, but it also gives it a texture so that when you start to paint them to paint in the details, it has something to cling to, as well as making it firmer and again reinforcing the mask, because you want this mask to last you throughout your Halloween and not fall apart in the middle of it and ruin your night. After painting it with the Mod Podge and letting it dry is when we are going to paint it with some acrylic paints. Again, I did start with the base color that I needed, but as you can tell when you watch The Nightmare Before Christmas, the characters do have dimension to their face, and these colors that they were not the exact colors I needed. So what I did was I mixed up some acrylic paints with, you know, the greens, the whites, all yada yada yada, to make the colors that I needed, and then I painted a couple coats onto the face. After that, I just went in with some black to de-stress it. So as you can see, along like the eyes, along the nose, and a couple like the edges of the mask, I put a little bit of a dry brush of black paint because it gave it more of a dimension. It made it look more real, and it kind of made it look like it was a mask that these kids have worn for many, 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 many Halloweens and beyond. And besides that, you do want to take a little bit of your black paint and paint along the inside of the eyes so that the foam that is sticking out is now seamlessly colored to go against your black eye fabric. For Beryl, I did add a bit of yellow and black to his teeth to make them stand out, because, you know, he's not the cleanest of the kids, so he's not gonna have like pure white teeth. And also, I actually did not leave the mask white. I made it kind of a bony blue color, and I know that bones are more like the shades of browns and yellows, but if you look at Tim Burton's movie, it's very like cool toned. To make sure he still matched that aesthetic, I painted it a more bluish and then added like little highlights of yellow. And so I added the yellow in the teeth. I also cut out the indentations of his nostrils and put a reinforcement of foam behind it so I could just paint in his nostrils black, but they actually go in from the face. I did also, much like Beryl, cut out the mouth of Locke around his teeth. So if you look at this, the teeth are part of the face of the mask, but I pasted a large piece of foam behind it to paint black so that his teeth stand out and kind of are a 3D effect on his face also. Then what you're gonna do is the part that involves that black fabric I was talking about. What I did was I cut out the approximate shape from that black fabric of each of the eyes. You know, smaller pieces for these, large pieces for these. And what you're gonna do is stretch that fabric over the empty eye sockets that you have in your mask. Now, I recommend kind of doing this very fast. It's a little hard, and this is the part I recommend not using hot glue. I would find something like super glue or fabric glue or something like that, because that's gonna stick best more so than the hot glue. Go along the outline of your eye while pressing down on the fabric to make sure that it is very tight along the inside of your mask. By doing that, you're ensuring that it's stretched out enough that you can see through it, because the importance of this mask is to be functional. I really wanted these masks to be functional, that I could see through, and I wasn't gonna wander around blind if I used them. So yes, put those things glue them, and then that part of your mask is all set. Now that might be a very fast kind of, you know, put together, hobble together kind of tutorial, but they're very, very, very simple masks to make. They only take like a day if you have the whole day, or maybe 2 days if you're doing it over a span of time and you don't have the hours to put into it, but they're not hard to make. I fully recommend doing it if you have the time or you really, really want to make them. They're a great group costume. There you have it. That is how I made Lock, Shock, and Barrel. If you have any other questions, just ask in the comments. I will respond to them as fast and as accurately as I can. I promise this is not a hard craft to do. It looks much more complicated than it is. I wish you a happy Halloween, and I will see you in my future videos very, very soon.